You could make the argument the way Aaron Boone could set it up would be Severino, Paxton, Tanaka, Corbin, but you're not paying him like a four. You're hoping he's kind of a co-two. Is that kind of fair to say?
I love the way you phrase that, and I think it becomes matchup heaven for Aaron Boone and for Larry Rothschild. We know Severino is the number one, and let's say you do slot Paxton in as two. Do you want to follow him up with a lefty who has somewhat similar stuff, or do you want to throw Tanaka out there from the right side with his sliders and his splitters? And then you bring back Corbin after that. So I think the Yankees have that ability. You, of course, would have CC Sabathia in that number five spot. And this, Bob, we should emphasize, this is their number one target. Cashman said at the outset of the offseason he wanted to get two pitchers. When I talked to him today at the stadium, he emphasized elite starting pitchers. They feel Paxton is number one, and the next guy on their target list is Corbin. They're taking him out to dinner tonight. They're wining and dining him. They showed him all that they had to offer at Yankee Stadium. And they're hoping that that recruitment effort works out.
By the way, we've talked about some of the other free agent pitchers. Not some bad options if Corbin decides to sign with somebody else. You got Dallas Keuchel out there. You got Jay Happ, who pitched very well in his stint with the Yankees last year. He could come back as well.
Yeah, Happ, I think, is a nice fallback option. I'm not saying Keuchel wouldn't be, but you don't hear the Yankees talking about Keuchel as much. They know who Happ is. They know what Happ can deliver for them. It's Happ's age right now that you would look at. Did a terrific job with the Yankees last season. If they failed to sign Corbin, I could see them turning toward Happ. But I think right now, especially from being out at the stadium today and seeing how excited the Yankees were to host Corbin, this is the guy they want to be able to add to the fold. To quote Cashman, he wants to be able to go up against every team in Major League Baseball and put the Yankees rotation out there and say, in a short series, they can beat anyone.
By the way, the Indians have supposedly put Carlos Carrasco out there, maybe Trevor Bauer, Corey Kluber. Is it possible the Yankees would pivot, or they want to stay away from their farm system, which has gotten a little more depleted with a few trades?
Very interesting question, Bob. I'll even throw Madison Bumgarner in there because there was some speculation that perhaps the Giants would be ready to move him. 1 year left on his deal before free agency. This is me speaking, just a hunch from the people that I've spoken to. I think right now the focus is Corbin. If they did have to pivot and potentially make a trade, I think the Yankees are always investigating all of those situations, but they did have to give up some players in the Paxton deal, so how much more of their farm system would they be willing to part with? You can get a free agent and just pay the salary, and we know what Hal Steimer has said. When the Yankees take money off from the year before, they're looking to spend that money and reinvest it. Corbin would be a great guy to reinvest it in.
If they do get him, what do you ultimately think the years and number will be?
Well, that's a great question. I think it's pushing toward 6 years with Corbin. Yeah. At the end of the offseason, I would have said 4 to 5, but there are enough teams interested in him now, Bob, that I see him potentially matching the offer that Yu Darvish got last year in the free agent market, which was 6 years, $126 million. I think Corbin could be right in that neighborhood.